skiers are made in the summer and the fall, not the winter. Here at Llewellyn, we don't just train from November to February. We train all year round so that we're in shape and ready for the season to come.
Every Friday after school on the third floor, for many years now, the runners, skiers, track and field athletes will meet.
After school, everyone wants to get out of the school as quick as possible, but we're always up in the third floor grinding it out.
I think the indoor training is key to our success as a team. Coming off the running season, we're usually in pretty good shape, but we need to start working strength.
Without strength, you won't really be able to really push hard in the races. I find the wall sit pretty challenging. Passing through that whole song, just sitting against that wall, but that definitely helps because you definitely need use a lot of your legs when you're racing.
The upper abs are the most important.
Your core is heavily involved with Nordic skiing.
Just with the double pull motion, you are crunching those upper abs every time you pull.
I look at the sprinting and the jumping in particular as two rather important elements for our indoor training.
Sally up is very challenging. After every practice, he brings food for us.
Over the last number of years, I have found many students looking forward to the Friday workout. So I see it as a good team building workout.
Running cross country in the off season really helps us as skiers. It basically gives you all the assets you need for cross-country skiing, and it's almost a seamless transition into the ski season after running season is over.
Spent your summer or fall with us in cross-country running, when we really get to work at the start of the ski season, you're already in good shape.
You've already established a base and you've had lots of fitness gains from that, so you can start the ski season very strong.
Northern Ontario is an ideal place for cross-country skiing because there's a lot of snow here during the winter.
We started skiing in November this year, and that's pretty regular we get to do that, so it's really nice to be able to go out and ski that early.
We don't have weeks where like you can't ski. It's a great place to get the most of a ski season.
We can learn to develop our skills way before the southern areas of Ontario. It's basically a huge advantage as we get to have more time to train.
Just the fact that we could get out on our skis early as November, that helps us out a lot. Gives that extra head start for the rest of the season.
The first few months are just kind of getting used to skis, and I think that's nice that you can have that time so much earlier.
Our main training facility is the Laurentian Nordic Center, and that's where we have most of our practices. It's awesome because it's just a few minutes walk away from the school, so everyone can get there right away, everyone gets set up.
That makes a big impact because you don't have to drive 30 minutes or 45 minutes just to get to a ski trail, so it makes it easy to just get out and ski like whenever you can if you can't make a practice.
They have a really awesome set of trails there. They have so many different loops that you can go on. They have just so many different options.
Being
on such a big team makes it a lot more fun. It makes it easier to finish those hard workouts. All the guys there to motivate you and to push you to the end.
When you see others having a good day, it motivates you just to try and do the same thing they are.
There's more people around your level skiing, so it's easier to find a good group to be with.
With any team like this, it's important to have a critical mass, a certain number of people there. And when you have that, the team operates better, the training seems less difficult.
Fun when we're not skiing too. Great environments, fun hanging out with the guys.
Teams just kind of carry on through like cross to skiing and then track, so by that time we all know each other really well too.
My favorite memory so far is probably ski school.
The LEP Ski School is basically a big day where our team is split up into separate groups, coming from beginner to advanced to intermediate.
The LEP Ski School is very good to help kickstart our intense training because it's right at the beginning of the season, and it's good for a lot of the newer skiers.
So this year there was going down a hill in like a pack, climbing hill, so we did the wall. We're lucky enough to have multiple coaches come up to basically every practice. So we have like Mr. Ward, who's great, and then Sarah and Neil, who come up to like alternate practice kind of. But they both are super helpful and know a lot about technique.
The way that you're getting the weight on the pole, the body's coming down.
For ski school, we also had people return. So like a lot of previous long skiers who all are doing competitive and like university now.
They've been through like the same experiences that we have, so that's good to mentor us on what to do and what not to do.
Sometimes you just do random games to help like improve technique and skill and stuff.
Go.
Sometimes they put beam bags on a hill and you have to like weave in between them or like pick one up to practice our tucking.
I like playing ski soccer over here.
I fall all the time anyways, so at least this way it like levels the playing field because everyone falls.
You just have one ski on and one ski off, so you can like ski around on one ski and kick the ball. The ski school potluck did not go very well for me. I got food poisoning from the potluck and we had a race the next day.
Post ski school potluck, we had a prelim, and half the team was sick because of one of the meals.
Two words, Mashinger's chili.
Headed to the first prelim, Windy Lake.
The boys are hyped up.
Our first prelim at the beginning of the season at Windy Lake, we just had a little cool down after, and it was super fun. It was a really nice day out, and it was just like a good introduction into the season. I'd say it's my favorite prelim.
Prelims are just really fun. They're hard races, but the stakes aren't as high, so you can work on a lot of different things while you're racing, but you're definitely improving your race skills while you're doing it. And it's almost like a field trip. We get to miss school for a day and take a bus out to one of our courses. How are you feeling, Ryan?
Dead. We've got a nice gray day here. We needed some intensity during exams. We don't want the athletes getting soft. So we opted for a time trial, a repeat of prelim number two. So they have a chance to better their time. If they don't better their time,
They've got some work to do.
They've got some work to do.
With skiing, one of the most important things you could do is get in the mileage.
Phase of our training plan at Llewellyn is mostly consisting of technique, and we go through the hard physical work to make it pay off at OFSAA.
When we start a build phase, you really get to see who has what it takes to compete at high levels.
I do a lot more workouts, we do ski a lot more, it's a lot more intensity based.
Start off your season, you're going to be a little rusty. The intensity will help you get your body used to what you're going to feel during a race. Being with the senior boys, it's so easy to be around them, and I can just be myself.
We motivate each other to ski just outside of school, like after school, like at night.
You're just improving every single practice and race. Being on the team, everyone pushes you forward at practices and races, and they just motivate you to do so much better.
Even going out and doing extra reps after the workout or doing more kilometers after your long ski, really as you extend your training, it helps you in the long run.
Well, usually we have a couple of days where we don't have a team practice, so usually I go skiing or I might work out on my own, and it really helps out.
Coaches help a lot for preparing us for the race coming in. First of all, we've got a great training plan, so even when we're far out from the races, we're getting ready for the races, and we're really good at adjusting our training plan coming to the race so we can taper properly, making sure everyone's healthy.
It's a good thing that we have multiple coaches, because sometimes we're thinking about multiple things at any given practice.
I think the coaches are amazing at helping us prepare for our races. I feel like they are very knowledgeable in the sport of skiing and are some of the best coaches we can have to help us prepare for a race.
I know all our coaches are volunteers, like they're going on their own time. They're always there to give us tips and stuff. That's definitely like the biggest part to my skiing, like how much I've improved over the last season.
Our coaches, like Mr. Ward, like Neil, and all of our friends, like make us want to be there. And I think that's what like helps us get through. And I find like that's when most of our like team bonding happens, is when we're all like suffering together.
Thank you.
I really liked all the night skis we've done. Senior boys have gone out for some late skis with the headlamps.
All like the late night skis that I've done with the senior boys, those have been really, really fun.
It's really fun just like going, especially with the new lit trails at night at Laurentian. Really nice to be able to have coaches who teach us and wax our skis for us.
We have many coaches on that, testing and waxing skis.
The wet, sticky snow definitely would be a deficit for your performance, but waxes will help repel the water off your base, and that makes a significant difference.
Rob Wiss, who waxes all our skis, that's really great because we need that to do well at these races.
Neil and Rob were like prepared to wax like 32 pairs of skis in like an hour. Like sometimes, especially when you're like racing just against your clock in like interval starts, even like a couple like seconds matters.
I think the thing about the community races that's so cool is that you have people from all ages and all over the city coming to race.
Racing against different people. We're used to racing against the high school racers, but we have the chance to race against skiers way older than us.
I remember the finals of the Walden Nightlights race was a couple high school racers, a couple coaches, some older guys, and even Laurentian skiers all racing in one big intense final, and it was so cool to watch.
Finishes are fast, snowing pretty hard, it's gonna be a good race.
The community races are awesome because other than the mandatory races, they really help us as want to be prepared and get on skis as much as you can. And having these small races can really help you prepare for the main ones like Cities, NASA, and OFSAA.
With all the community races that go on during the season, it's always good to have more practice around race time, and you even have more competition because a lot of the club skiers will be there.
course at Cities was an interesting one. A huge climb at the beginning that you really just gotta hammer hard, followed by a long rest section.
The course was actually really fun. I liked it a lot, even though it was pretty tough for the first three.
Having the purple and yellow race suits like just shining through the trees is sick, because you go around a turn, you see another Llewellyn. Like at one point there was just a huge pack.
It's
really nice when you're out there and you're seeing most of the crowd is Llewellyn, you're seeing our race suits, our jackets.
I always love seeing them on course. Super fun to cheer for them.
Honestly, it kind of like moves you. You go faster because all your friends are there and like pushing you.
Near the end of the race, you're gonna want to give it all you got, because it's the end. You just gotta empty the tank. You gotta finish on empty.
Everyone left everything they had out there. When Kendon and I were catching guys out there, we liked what we saw. The guys were hustling out there.
You really feel proud of yourself and accomplished after you've known you've pushed yourself in that hard race.
You put in a lot of hard training.
Even if it was a bad race, I usually learned something from it.
Nobody dropped out, nobody got hurt, nobody had a bad race.
Overall, just looking at everybody's results, we all performed really well.
Yeah, it was pretty good. Took it off pretty easy, and then last kilometer ripped hard.
I actually paced that very well today and ended up like pretty consistent throughout the whole race, so I was pretty happy.
Aaron, what about you?
A little fast on the first one. Overall, still had a good race.
Great rip out there. I was surprised that it wasn't able to catch McLovin. McLovin is pretty darn good now.
North Bay is the host city for NASA this year, and it's definitely going to be different than Cities, because it's not just going to be Llewellyn, it's not going to be like you know everybody there, it's going to be a bunch of other skiers that are equal, maybe even better than you, that you really need to prove yourself.
All right, good standby.
Everything went well at NASA. It was a nice day, weather was perfect, skiers were having fun and skiing well, the relays were exciting.
The team's definitely progressed at an extremely fast rate this season.
Most of us have come a long way from where we were at the start of the season.
All the beginners, they just got out, they didn't know how to ski, some of them are getting pretty fast now. I am nothing, I
am nothing. You. We are really seeing some tremendous gains out of the athletes.
The team has progressed in sort of building blocks for sure, so like some people could hardly stand up and now they're skiing like a 7K race.
Like I started my first day and I was like completely on the ground falling. Every race as it goes on, I feel better and better.
I think for sure Llewellyn is the dominating team in the north.
Eat lots of food, sleep lots, then eat lots of food, and we'll check for a breakfast schedule. I know I'm going Friday and Saturday.
Are you ready for OFSAA?
Yes.
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 Oh yeah.
100%.
Yes, sir.
Oh yeah, that's a tough one.
Hell yeah.
Oh yeah.
Okay, am I ready for OFSAA? Okay.
Sure I am.
100%. I don't want to say something lame.
Am I ready for OFSAA?
Yes.
Yes, kind of.
Definitely not.
No.
Definitely not.
Okay. Oh, it's gonna be a tough one.
Can we come back?
Hell yeah.
Just ask McLovin.
Definitely.
I'm just gonna come back to this question.
Oh yeah.
What am I gonna say for that?
If you don't have to say anything.
No, I do wanna say it. It's okay. A good question.
Yes, always ready for OFSAA.
All I need to say is, of course I'm ready for OFSAA. I've been training, I've been waiting for it all year.
Moving on to OFSAA, we'd definitely be able to compete at a high level.
This year, some of us certainly can go there and dream big. I know there's some tough competition.
It's not the same people you've competed against all year.
Especially at OFSAA, every skier there is an amazing skier. It's insanely tough to get any ribbons, medals, even a banner.
But we're also strong too, so we have to think like that and be confident.
It'll be different. It'll be tougher than what we see here in the north. But we train hard and we work hard here, so I think we'll be able to do it for sure.
Especially this year, leading into OFSAA, the stakes are really high because last year we had one of the best years of our school's history.
It's the last year for a lot of us who came here early on, the start of the Llewellyn ski dynasty, if I could call it that, so add some pressure.
Handling that pressure is really the next stage of our development.
We've gotten to know a lot of the competitors in Ontario, so we've been communicating with them, we've been talking with them about who we think is going to win, who's going to be more successful at OFSAA, so stakes are probably a bit higher this year.
I know the senior girls faced like the challenge of having like all their club skiers like moving away from Llewellyn.
It's super important at OFSAA that all of the skiers on the teams have a good race because it really comes down to everyone's results and especially that third and fourth skier.
You know, you can't really improve your fitness at this point, but you can improve by getting a really good sleep and eating really well.
What I eat is important, my mentality is important.
Like Ward likes to say, control the controllables, that's something you can control.
Going into OFSAA, I think the most important thing the athlete needs to consider is a positive mindset and a willingness to prepare and do the little things.
I like to get myself mentally prepared. It really helps to, even the day before, constantly tell yourself you're gonna perform well.
Well, there's some serious competition for sure between Llewellyn and Huntsville. Seen it on the social media. They've got a strong team, so do we. I think everyone's been training hard. Should be a good battle there.
I think we'll be able to take home, hopefully, a banner for senior boys.
Well, I think the biggest challenge will be to try to medal at OFSAA, because that's what we're going for right now. I'm hoping that on my team, the junior boys, we can get one.
Our team looks really good, and that's like pretty much the goal for our junior team and what we've been looking for this season.
A lot of the guys we've had here right now, we've had for a while. We've seen them develop, and they've had some success in the last few years, so I think there's no doubt that we have a chance for some medals and some banners this year.
Get a little nervous, then I stumble and I hesitate. Never take a chance because I'm too afraid my heart will break. Everything I ever wanted standing right in front of me. But I think that I'm running from the only one I really need. Time stands still, and I'm feeling so much, and it's all right here, and I just gotta trust that you're the one. The time has come, so tell me, baby, what's it gonna take? We can be the champions, we can own the night. Yeah, it might destroy us, but we gotta try. Can't keep looking backwards, running from the light. So now and I can feel it in my blood. Something about your energy that moves me every time we touch. Worshipping the only thing that's always playing on my mind.
so much and it's all right here. And I just gotta trust that you're the one. Time has come, so tell me baby what's going on. We can be the champions, we can own the night.
I love skiing because like you get to go outside all the time and enjoy like taking the sun, and it's a good way just to get out with friends.
All the people that do it just make it so much better.
Like a nice environment, and you get to be with friends, you get exercise, and it keeps your body healthy.
Probably what I love the most about skiing is just like being out with a good group of people and just having fun.
Getting out with new friends I met this year in the ski team.
The thing I love the most about skiing is probably my teammates.
I think what I love the most about skiing is the team. I've made a lot of friends through skiing. It's just like really fun to come to practices and stuff.
I really like coaching Nordic skiing because I find it's a great way to be outdoors with students, and I love the students that participate. I always have lots of people to cheer for, so that's kind of fun.
I love the experience hanging out with like all my friends, having like that close group.
I like, yeah, like the friends part of it and like being part of the team is probably the best part about skiing. It's all like overall been like one of the more fun seasons.
I think just the team and like the whole atmosphere about it, like it's just fun to go to the races and like have a group of people that really just enjoy it and you can have fun with.
Something I love the most about skiing is the long, easy skis with all the boys. We're having fun, talking, joking around. Those are the best skis.
I think without a doubt, this was the best season of my high school career. I think the team as a whole is much closer together now throughout the season. We bonded so much. I think I've met so many amazing people and a lot of people that are now my best friends. Practicing with them and going on long skis with all your best friends is one of the best experiences I can ever ask for.
Well, I helped a lot of the beginners, so seeing them like cross the finish line and, you know, how much they'd grown, that was really exciting.
The thing I love the most about Nordic skiing and coaching it is the fact that we've been able to bring a large amount of people and introduce them to the sport, bring them to a relatively high level, and we've at the same time given them a skill set that hopefully they'll be able to take forward for the rest of their lives.